Hello students, in this class you have to study the most important chemical reactions of the phenol, that is named reactions. First named reaction is Reimer-Tyman reaction. In majority papers they can ask Reimer-Tyman, or one more is the Kolbe's reaction. Out of Reimer-Tyman and Kolbe's, any one of the reaction they compulsorily ask for the 2 marks. Reimer-Tyman reaction means, first consider in theoretical words, when phenol treated with chloroform. Chloroform formula is CHCl3. Chloroform in the presence of sodium hydroxide, sodium salt of salicylaldehyde. This is the intermediate. This on acidification, sodium salt of salicylaldehyde on acidification forms salicylaldehyde. This reaction is called Reimer-Tyman reaction. This carries 1 mark. Phenol treated with chloroform in the presence of sodium hydroxide, sodium salt of salicylaldehyde is formed, which on acidification salicylaldehyde is formed. Or you write the self-explanatory reaction. Self-explanatory means, first you consider the reaction. On below that reactant, name the compound phenol. This is self-explanatory. Phenol, when treated with chloroform, CHCl3 and NaOH. Chloroform and NaOH. First it forms a reactive intermediate. This is the intermediate form. O minus Na plus CHCl2. This is the intermediate. If you know this formula, write this intermediate. Otherwise, no need of writing the intermediate also. You get this intermediate. This intermediate further reacts with NaOH, sodium hydroxide. You get, this is the compound, O minus Na plus CHO. This is called sodium salt of salicylaldehyde. Sodium salt of salicylaldehyde. Phenol treated with chloroform in the presence of sodium hydroxide. Sodium salt of salicylaldehyde. This on acidification, that salicylaldehyde on acidification forms, this is the product OHCHO. CHO is introduced, aldehyde group is introduced at the ortho position. This is the ortho. CHO at the ortho position, the name is salicylaldehyde. This is also called as the ortho hydroxybenzaldehyde. Another name of the salicylaldehyde is ortho hydroxybenzaldehyde. Just you follow this reaction as it is, definitely you get the 2 marks. Explain Reimer-Tyman reaction means, just write the self-explanatory part only. Just you practice this reaction, definitely you get the 2 marks. Phenol treated with chloroform in presence of sodium hydroxide. Sodium, if you know this formula, write this formula. Otherwise, directly you write ONaCHO. Sodium salt of salicylaldehyde. This on acidification, forms salicylaldehyde. For competitive, you have to familiar with this name also. Ortho-hydroxybenzaldehyde. Then one more, for competitive point of view, you have to consider that electrophile use repeatedly in competitive exam, they are asking this question. The electrophile used in Reimer-Tymon reaction is dichlorocarbene. This is dichlorocarbene. Dichlorocarbene. This is most important one. For the competitive point, the electrophile used in the Reimer-Tymon reaction is dichlorocarbene, CCl2, dichlorocarbene. This is about the Reimer-Tymon reaction. This is also one of the that electrophilic substitution reaction. Next, to consider the Kolbe's reaction. Second one is Kolbe's reaction. Either Reimer-Tymon or Kolbe's. In majority papers, they are asking this Kolbe's reaction. Kolbe's reaction means the sodium phenoxide form. Sodium phenoxide or sodium phenate also. Sodium phenoxide form by the reaction of phenol and sodium hydroxide. If you treat phenol with sodium hydroxide, sodium phenoxide is formed. Sodium phenoxide formed by the reaction of phenol and NaOH. Treated with that sodium phenoxide is treated with carbon dioxide. Treated with the carbon dioxide. Then you get sodium salt of salicylic acid. Sodium salt of salicylic acid. Which on acidification, that salt on acidification, we get salicylic acid. Salicylic acid. This reaction is called Kolbe's reaction. Most important. Sodium phenoxide formed by the reaction of phenol and NaOH. Treated with carbon dioxide. Sodium salt of salicylic acid is formed. Which on acidification salicylic acid is formed. You have to write the reaction. First you consider phenol. Then phenol treated with NaOH, sodium hydroxide. This is phenol. Even if you write the self-explanatory, at that time also you get the full marks. Then intermediate, that is sodium phenoxide, ONA, O minus Na plus. This is called sodium phenoxide, or even sodium phenate. Sodium phenate is also correct. Sodium phenoxide. This sodium phenoxide treated with carbon dioxide. Followed by acidification, they are not mentioned the intermediate salt. Directly we are considering the salicylic acid. Hence, first step is sodium phenoxide form treated with carbon dioxide followed by acidification. Directly I am considering the product, that is OHCOOH. This is called salicylic acid. Salicylic acid. Just you write this reaction only, you get the full marks with the names. Salicylic acid. The salicylic acid and also another name is orthohydroxy. Orthohydroxy. If OH is not considered, then the remaining is benzoic acid. Hence, orthohydroxy benzoic acid. Orthohydroxybenzoic acid. ऑर्थोहाइड्रॉक्सी बेंजोइक एसिड कॉमनली कॉल्ड सैलिसिलिक एसिड. दिस इज अबाउट द कोल बेस्ड रिएक्शन. एवरी स्टूडेंट मस्ट फॉलो राइमर टाइमर एंड कोल बेस्ड रिएक्शन. इफ यू फॉलो दिस टू रिएक्शन डेफिनेटली यू गेट द 2 marks. देन वन मोर रिएक्शन बाई यूजिंग दिस सैलिसिलिक एसिड. We can convert the salicylic acid into aspirin. Salicylic acid into aspirin. How can you convert? This is salicylic acid. How can you convert salicylic acid into aspirin? Means by treating with acetyl chloride. This is acetyl chloride. Acetyl chloride. Or acetic anhydride, acetyl chloride in the presence of concentrated H2SO4, in the presence of concentrated H2SO4, this H and Cl get removed, HCl get removed, then the product is O from this CO CH3. Remaining COOH remains same. This is called aspirin. Aspirin. Chemical name of aspirin is acetyl. This is acetyl CH3CO. Acetyl salicylic acid. For competitive, you have to remember the chemical name of the aspirin. Aspirin chemical name is acetyl salicylic acid. Acetyl salicylic acid. The important use of this aspirin is behaves as an analgesic. For 1 mark, it is important. Analgesic as well as antipyretic. In chemistry, in everyday life, we are used this analgesics and antipyretics. Analgesics means which reduce the body pain, which reduce the body pain. Antipyretics means which lowers the body temperature. The role of this aspirin is used as an analgesic as well as antipyretic. They can ask this question for 1 mark. Name the drug behaves both as an analgesic and antipyretic. The answer is aspirin. How aspirin prepared means by treating salicylic acid. Salicylic acid treated with acetyl chloride, even acetic anhydride. Just I am using acetyl chloride. Acetyl chloride in the presence of concentrated sulfuric acid, aspirin is formed, liberating HCl. The chemical name of the aspirin is acetyl salicylic acid. Next, you consider reaction with zinc dust. Next one is reaction. Reaction with zinc dust. For 1 mark, it is useful. Already in first year hydrocarbons, you have studied this reaction. When phenol treated with zinc dust, this ZnO get removed. The remaining product is, this is the product. ZnO is removed. This is called benzene. This is phenol. Phenol treated with zinc dust, benzene is formed. The last property of the phenol is oxidation. Oxidation. When phenol on oxidation, phenol on oxidation by using chromic acid. Formula is H2CrO4. They are not using this chromic acid. Instead of chromic acid, they are using Na2Cr2O7, sodium dichromate or potassium. Instead of Na, K2Cr2O7, potassium dichromate or sodium dichromate in presence of concentrated H2SO4. If you treat sodium dichromate with concentrated H2SO4, we get the chromic acid. In our syllabus, they are giving phenol treated with sodium dichromate and sulfuric acid. Instead of this one, they can also use chromic acid. In competitive level, they are using the chromic acid. The product phenol undergo oxidation to form this product. This is most important one. This is the product formula. Double bond O, double bond O. This is called benzoquinone. Benzoquinone. Most important one. For one mark, they are considering phenol, aromar, sodium dichromate, sulfuric acid. Complete the equation. For one mark only, they are using this question. The product is an benzoquinone. Phenol on oxidation. Phenol on oxidation. Benzoquinone is formed. This is about the properties of the phenol. This phenol chapter is very most important. You have to practice either cumene process or by using diazonium salt or chemical properties, Reimer-Tamman reaction, Kolbe's reaction, or with concentrated HNO3 or oxidation property. Then one more for the competitive point. And for that practical purpose, in practical they are asking the viva question. Phenol not touch with bare hands. Phenol not touch with bare hands. If phenol falls on the skin, it will produce the white patches. White patches means blisters. White blisters are formed. Phenol not touch with bare hands. Bare hands. Why phenol not touch with bare hands means it forms the blisters. When it falls on the skin, it forms blisters, means patches, white patches. Hence phenol not touch with the bare hands. Next, one more. Phenol is acidic in nature. Already we have studied phenol is an acid. Acid means they have to liberate carbon dioxide from carbonates and the bicarbonates. Phenol is an acid. If you treat with carbonate acid radical or bicarbonate acid radical, they have to evolve the carbon dioxide. But phenol not liberate, phenol not evolves carbon dioxide from sodium carbonate or with sodium bicarbonate. This is important for the viva question. Why phenol not evolves carbon dioxide from carbonate and bicarbonate? Or phenol not decompose, it not decompose carbonates and bicarbonates. Instead of not liberate carbon dioxide, they use the word phenol not decompose sodium carbonate and bicarbonate. If carbonate and bicarbonate decompose, then only carbon dioxide is evolved. Hence, they can ask in this forum also, phenol not liberate carbon dioxide from carbonates and bicarbonates, or phenol not decompose carbonates and bicarbonates. Main reason is phenol is weaker acid. It is a weak acid. It is weaker acid than the carbonic acid. Phenol is weaker acid than the carbonic acid. Carbonic acid formula is H2CO3. Phenol is weaker than the carbonic acid. Hence, phenol not decompose carbonates and the bicarbonate. These are about the phenols.